On this farm, we have installed a GreenFeed station, which is a part of the methane project by Geno. And the goal is that we can find cows with lower methane emissions and also with higher feed efficiency, which should be good both for the environment and for the farmer's economy. So this is the green feed station that is placed around the country, and what happens is that a cow is coming in, and when she gets into the station, she is identified via her ear tag, and then she gets a little bit of concentrate, and when the cow is standing there eating the concentrate, all the gases from the breathing and the burps and everything are sucked into the machine, and it passes different sensors and goes out to this air again. Hello, Sverre.
Hello, John Erik. How is things? All well?
Yeah, it's okay. I've just done the daily maintenance and checked that everything is working and as it should. Yeah, so. Do you have enough data so far to see that this is related to the genetics?
So far this year we have some 700 cows with all the machines in all the farms with the data, so we have plenty to work with for the researchers to look into this and see if this is something we should take into the breeding system. We are quite sure that climate efficiency and methane emissions are very close linked to feed efficiency. The less methane emission, the higher the feed efficiency, because methane is energy in the feed just going up in the air instead of being used to produce milk and meat in the cow. So this is very important, and it's sort of a win-win situation for the farmer and the climate. We can save the planet at the same time as the farmer also earns more money, or said in another way, he saves feed costs.
What is Geno looking for in a long term?
The ultimate goal and the results we are aiming for with this project is that when we have collected enough data and when we have enough calculations, we can use these data to put breeding values on methane emissions and feed efficiency on the bulls that you are going to choose for your cows in a few years. And this should be interesting also for other countries. Of course, they need to calculate what's their cost from the feed and so on, and what are the prices for the products they sell, and then they can choose between the bulls which bull is the best match for their production.